Hello everyone, welcome back. In today's session, we'll take up lesson 45, A Clear Conscience. 大家好，今天呢，我们要学习第45课 A Clear Conscience, 意思是问心无愧。This story is very interesting. It took place in a small village. 这个故事呢很有趣，发生在一个小村子里边。It is about a man who had lost a large sum of money while taking his savings to the post office. 故事讲的是一个人去邮局存款的途中呢，丢了一大笔钱。Well, you'll soon learn about the story, but now,Let's look at the keywords and expressions first.
下面呢，我们先看一看课文中出现的关键词和短语。
Conscience. A clear conscience. Sam Benton. Sam Benton 是故事中的一个人名。Butcher.Savings, villager, percent
也可以连写 percent.
Okay, before you look at the flash, please keep these questions in mind.
在大家看动漫之前，先来看看这几个问题。
What did Sam Benton lose while taking his savings to the post office?
Sam Benton 去邮局存款的时候丢了什么东西?
What happened after 3 months passed?
三个月过去以后发生了什么事情?
How did the thief pay back the money?
小偷是如何把这些钱还回来的?
The whole village soon learned that a large sum of money had been lost. Sam Benton, the local butcher, had lost his wallet while taking his savings to the post office. Sam was sure that the wallet must have been found by one of the villagers, but it was not returned to him.3 months passed, and then one morning, Sam found his wallet outside his front door. It had been wrapped up in newspaper, and it contained half the money he had lost, together with a note which said, A thief, yes, but only 50% a thief. 2 months later,Some more money was sent to Sam, with another note. Only 25% a thief now. In time, all Sam's money was paid back in this way. The last note said, I am 100% honest now.
Well, how do you like the story? I think you must have enjoyed it as much as I have.Well, as usual, I'm going to repeat the questions, and you please try to answer the questions along with me.
好，像往常一样，我还把这些问题提出来，请大家试着跟我一起来回答。
The first question is, What did Sam Benton lose while taking his savings to the post office?
Sam Benton.在把他的存款送往邮局的途中丢了什么东西?
Sam Benton lost his wallet on his way to the post office.
他在去邮局的途中呢丢了一个钱包。
The next question, What happened after 3 months passed?
三个月过去以后发生了什么事情?
After 3 months passed, Sam found his wallet outside his front door.
Sam Benton 在三个月以后呢，在他的门前发现了他自己的钱包。 It contained half the money he had lost, together with a note which said, "A thief, yes, but only 50% a thief."
这个钱包里边呢，有他丢失的钱款的一半。钱包里边还附着一张纸条，纸条上是这样说的：小偷是的，但是只是一个50%的小偷。
The last question. How did the thief pay back the money?
那么这个小偷是如何把这些钱还回来的呢？
The thief returned some more money each time and always included a note.
这个小偷每次都送回来一些钱，并且呢总是附着一张纸条。
The last note said,I am 100% honest now.
最后一张纸条上是这么说的，我现在已经是一个100%的诚实人了。
OK, now let's look at the language points.
下面呢，我们就来看一看本课中的语言点。
The whole village soon learned that a large sum of money had been lost.
全村的人很快就知道有一大笔钱丢失了。在这个句子中，注意 the whole village 实际上代表的是全村的人这样的一个意思。一大笔钱在英文中要用 a large sum of money 来表示，一笔钱呢就是 a sum of money。
had been lost
是被动语态，而且呢是过去完成时的被动语态。
Sam Benton, the local butcher, had lost his wallet while taking his savings to the post office.
当地的屠户 Sam Benton 在把他的存款送往邮局的途中丢了他的钱包。在这个句子中
the local butcher
是对 Sam Benton 的说明，要用逗号点开。
While taking his savings to the post office,
相当于说 while he was taking his savings to the post office. 那么我们来看看这样一个用法，请看例句。
He cut himself while shaving.
他在刮脸的时候把脸刮破了。那么这个句子也可以说
he cut himself while he was shaving.
While 这个连词还可以跟介词短语连用，请看下一个例句。
While in Vienna, he studied music.
他在维也纳期间学习音乐。好，我们再看下一个句子。
Sam was sure that the wallet must have been found by one of the villagers, but it was not returned to him.
Sam 确信那个钱包一定是被某个村民捡到了，可是呢却不见有人来送还给他。
Must have been found
表示一种推测。
Be sure
是对什么东西肯定确信什么。我们来看看例句。
He is sure that his plan will work.
他肯定他的计划会成功。
He is not sure whether his plan will work or not.
那么，对什么事情不能肯定呢？可以用这样的形式来表达。
Be not sure,
后面跟 whether 引导的一个从句。他不敢肯定他的计划是否能成功。好，我们再看下一句。
It contained half the money he had lost, together with a note which said, "A thief, yes, but only 50% a thief."
钱包里边有他丢失的一半的钱款，并且呢还附着一张纸条，说一个小偷是的，但只是50%的小偷。
Half the money 等于 half of the money. 50% a thief 等于说 50% of a thief. 同样 25% a thief 等于 25% of a thief. 下面我们再来看看 percent 的用法。I am 100% honest now. 我现在是百分之百的诚实了。这里 100% 是修饰 honest. I am 100% sure. 我百分之百的肯定。同样 100% 修饰 sure. 我们再来看看 together with 的用法。He sold the house together with the furniture. 他把房子连同家具一块卖了。Together with 是连同什么的意思。John, together with his brother, has gone to the party. 约翰和他的兄弟一块去参加聚会去了。请大家注意，这里主语是 John, 所以呢谓语中要用 has gone 这样的动词形态。 Together with his brother 是一个介词短语，是一个插入的成分。好，我们再看下一个语言点。 2 months later, some more money was sent to Sam with another note. 两个月以后，又有一些钱送还给 Sam， 并且呢，还附了一张纸条。那么请大家注意一下 more 的用法，请看一下例句。 Would you like some more soup? 你想再来些汤吗？ I need some more time. 我还需要一些时间。好，我们再看下一个语言点。 In timeAll Sam's money was paid back in this way. In time, 意思是过了一段时间，最终。我们来看一个例句。In time, you learn everything. 最终你会知道一切的。In this way, 是以这种方式。That's all for the language points. Now we'll move on to the next segment, key structure and usage. 那么在这个部分呢，我们要看看被动语态。The whole village soon learned that a large sum of money had been lost. Had been lost. 被动语态，过去完成时。Sam was sure that the wallet must have been found by one of the villagers, but it was not returned to him. 这里有两个被动语态，一个是 must 后面加上 have been found， 还有一个是 was not returned. It had been wrapped up in newspaper.这里的被动语态是 had been wrapped up. 2 months later, some more money was sent to Sam with another note. 这里的被动语态是 was sent. In time, all Sam's money was paid back in this way. 被动语态的基本构成形式是由 be 动词加上动词的过去分词构成，那么根据需要可以把 be 动词用各种时态形式来体现。在今天的课文里，我们学了问心无愧的说法 a clear conscience。 那么问心有愧怎么说呢？其实我们只要把 clear 换一个词就可以了，那就是 a guilty conscience。 Well, the story is really interesting because the thief has some sense of humor. 这个故事呢很有趣，因为这个小偷很有一些幽默感。The story also gives us a glimpse of the English village life. 这个故事呢让我们看到了英国一个乡村生活的一个有趣侧面。 OK, that's it for today's lesson. See you next time.